Hello friends, welcome to Slide Hunt with C programming video tutorial. And in this tutorial I am gonna teach you how to pass value to a function, and it is called a pass by value. Here we gonna create a function called swap, and the function swap takes two integer type parameters. So first do the prototyping, void swap, and within parentheses write the type of the parameter, that is integer. Next, inside the main function I am gonna create two integer type variable, int a which is initialized to 30 and int b which is initialized to 50. Next, we use a printf function to print the value of a and b. So I am gonna write here printf a equal to %d and b equal to %d, and we need to refer a and b. Next, we call the swap function which pass two parameter a and b. Now we need to define the swap function, so I am gonna write here void swap and within parentheses write the parameter, that is integer x and integer y. Inside the body of the function I am gonna print the value of x and y, so write here printf, and I am gonna write here x equal to %d and y equal to %d, and we have to refer x and y. Let's check the output, compile it and run it. As you can see here, it print a equal to 30 and b equal to 50, and then x equal to 30 and y equal to 50, because here we initialize a equal to 30 and b equal to 50. That's why it print a equal to 30 and b equal to 50. Then we call the swap function and pass the value of a and b. Here x contain the s value, means value of a is copied to x and value of b is copied to y. That's why it print x equal to 30 and y equal to 50. The main purpose of this tutorial is that when we pass this value to a function, means when we pass the value of a and b, a is copied to x and b is copied to y. In memory, a and b is in some memory space and x and y in some other memory space. Suppose this is a computer memory, then a is in one place, b is in one place, x hold one place and y hold some other place. A containing the value 30, b containing the value 50. When call the swap function, a is copied to x and b is copied to y. That's mean x containing 30 and y containing 50. If we change the value of x and y here, then the value of x and y will change in this memory location. The changing of value in x and y will not affect the value of a and b, because a and b are stored in some other memory location. Okay, let's move to the coding. Now we swap the value of the variables x and y. To do this we need another variable, so I am gonna declare here int temp. First we copy the value of the variable x to the temporary variable temp, so write here temp equal to x. Then copy the value of the variable y to the x, so I am gonna write here x equal to y and then y equal to temp. These three statements swap the value of the variable x and y. Next we print the value of the variable x and y. So I am gonna write here printf after swapping x equal to %d and y equal to %d, and we have to refer x and y. And I am gonna write here before swapping inside the main function, after this function call we print the value of the variable a and b, so I am gonna copy it and paste here, and I am gonna write here after function call and here I am gonna write before function calling. Let's check the output, compile it and run it. As you can see here, it print before function calling a is 30 and b is 50. Because here we assign a equal to 30 and b equal to 50. Then we call the swapping function and the control transfer here. Then it print before swapping x equal to 30 and y equal to 50. Because value of a is copied to x and value of b is copied to the variable y. That's why it print x equal to 30 and y equal to 50. Next, we swap the value of the variable x and y using these three statements and then print the value. That's why it print after swapping x equal to 50 and y equal to 30. When the swapping function finishes its execution, the value of x and y will be lost and it returns back to the main function. The changing in values of x and y will not affect the value of a and b because they are stored in different memory location. That's why it print after function calling a equal to 30 and b equal to 50, which is still remain the same. That's it. Hope you understand. See you next tutorial. Thank you for watching this video. To watch more videos, please subscribe this channel.